Krispy Kreme!
I wonder why I'm craving suddenly Krispy Kreme. I don't know why. What is up, Humanoid Nation and Power Ranger fans? So, just got back from watching a Power Rangers movie. Okay, first off, I'd like to say, yes, I know this is a reimagining, a reboot, a different way of showing it, but also keeping faithful to the source material. So with that in mind, I went with this with an open mind, unlike other people who are still saying like, that's not Power Rangers, that's not Power Rangers. Okay, it's a new, different version. Although, I did enjoy it. I really did. But also, there's some stuff I didn't like, which I will say at the end. First off, let's just say, the opening scene, the Zootopia era, whatever it was called. Nice there. The Zootopia era, really? Ha. Gee, I wonder what the next movie's gonna be. The Zeo Crystal, the Great MacGuffin, as it once was. Hey, at least they put the Zeo Crystals in this. Yeah. And with that, I gotta say, also, the opening scene, you know, Saban, for a guy who said he did not like the unauthorized Power Ranger movie from YouTube that got banned, gee, that opening scene sure looks familiar. It sure does. Where have I seen that before? That scene and the one where Rita just went all apeshit on that guy with the gold tooth in the alley, because it looks familiar too. In the unauthorized version where like Tommy's a hobo and just walking around the streets. Not killing people, but it reminds me of that scene too. But let's rewind. So, the original Rangers. I guess they're the original Rangers. I'm guessing since Zordon was a former Red Ranger, which I found awesome. By the way, he's an old warrior. And all the Rangers, the first Rangers were basically aliens. Okay, I accept it. Because Zordon is an alien. Yeah, and he was the Red Ranger, which is amazing. And the Pink Ranger dies. Oh. And then Zordon dies. There's a lot of dying in this movie. They were not playing around with this movie. This ain't your PG kid-friendly thing. So yeah, Zordon dies. Rita supposedly dies and shit. Then we go to Angel Grove, which is now. And we got our main people that are playing the Power Rangers. Zachary Montgomery playing Jason, who's an asshole in the beginning. But then becomes the leader. We got Billy, played by RJ Seiler, who I'm pretty sure Billy is either autistic or has Asperger's, however you say that name. Yeah, because he reminds me of Drax from the Guardians of the Galaxy. It's like, doesn't get the jokes. But Billy's pretty cool, like the smart one, and he's always doing this. I love that. I just do. But Billy, man, he's hilarious though. Even though he's autistic, he doesn't know when to stop. It's like he's talking about his dead father and all, and Jason doesn't know what the hell he's talking about. Yeah. And he works in his basement, which is pretty cool, because like Billy in the original show worked in his garage, which is close to the basement, so I guess that's a cool thing. Then you got Naomi Scott, who I didn't know was British or Australian or whatever the fuck she is, playing Kimberly Hart. She's the mean girl, apparently. Although I never seen her being a mean girl. She just said she was a mean girl later on. And her two friends who, from Black Nerd Comedy, deemed them Balkina and Skullina, because he didn't know if they were actually Balk and Skull, the female version, but no, they're just her friends who kicked her out of the group. And because of that, Kimberly cuts her hair for some reason. And suddenly all the guys in detention find her hotter. Excuse me. She was hotter with long hair, but okay, whatever. Yeah. And it was like the Breakfast Club, because every Saturday until summer's over. So, yeah. There's some Breakfast Club type shenanigans going on here. And whoever that bully is with the red hair, that goofy looking motherfucker taking on Billy, that guy, holy crap, how is he in high school? He's a psychotic motherfucker because he wants to break Billy's fingers when he sees him next time. It's like, I'm going to break every one of your fingers and shit. I'm going like, God damn, dude. This is Power Rangers? Shit. And like, the guy tries to knock him out, but he winds up being knocked out by Billy because Billy's hard as a rock. All of a sudden, the girls turn whore on him and go like, hey, Billy. And go like, and as soon as that happened, I go like, who's? And the guy behind me told me, really, bro? Really? And he started laughing. Yeah. Oh yeah, we got Becky G playing Trini. Not much is known about her. She just shows up and apparently she's into mischief. And I'm still wondering, because I looked up on IMDb to see if Trini has a last name, to see if it's Trini Kwan. But no, her name is Trini. But still, I'm wondering what kind of Latino parents names their daughter Trini if they're Latino. I never heard of a Latino girl named Trini. That's just me saying that. But also, I never heard of an Asian person named Zach. But whatever. Oh yeah, Trini lives with her family, of course. With her two unknown brothers who have no name in this movie. They're just brother number one and brother number two. Yeah. Zach lives in a trailer park, but he loves to hang out in an abandoned train. And his mom has cancer, leukemia, something that's killing her, never explained. But apparently she's good at the end because she feels all better because the Power Rangers saved the day. I guess the cureness is the Power Rangers, but what? Yeah, Zach, he's the rebel of the group. It's like, or the crazy one, which he always says, it's like, I'm the crazy one. Yeah, yeah. No, you're kind of the dumb one, just going into battle and like taking a mastodon out for a joyride into public view and no one says a damn thing. No one reports that a giant mastodon looking robot is running around until the very end. I'm pretty sure that mastodon did some destruction when they went on a joyride, but whatever. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I gotta say about that. And, alright. The spaceship where the command center is, it's kind of difficult to get there. You gotta go up the mountains, which are like the quarry or whatever, which I get, because in the original show it was like, in the quarry was rocks all over the place. But yeah, in the show you just teleport there and you're easy there, and the only way you can get in is through the power coin, which they did say in this movie too. He's like, only entrance through the power was a power coin and all that shit. But yeah, you gotta walk the quarry, go where the rocks are, go over that shit, jump into a ravine where the water is, swim down the ravine, go into a portal that seems like Zeo, the first episode of Zeo at the end of season 3 where the command center blew up and the new command center, the power chamber got built, and they found the entranceway, which is a zone shit thing, and they're touching it and they're slowly going in, and this is what reminded me of here. So yeah, but then they go inside the thing and they go upside down and shit, and it becomes right side up. It's kind of difficult. That's really confusing. God damn, Billy, you better invent those communicators for the seagull, man, because like doing all that shit is fucking distracting. I'm pretty sure that's what he was planning when he was looking into the morphing grid and just writing down notes because Alpha was telling him stuff and he wasn't listening. Yeah, but that's just confusing as shit. Alright, as for Alpha, I gotta admit, he's grown on me. Because I see him in trailers and I'm going like, this motherfucker right here, he looks really weird. But Bill Hader, I gotta say, did a good job playing Alpha because he was a sarcastic guy. Very laid back, but still kind of an asshole. And he only said the I catchphrase once because, like, Of course, he's only going to say it once because it was at that proper moment where you're allowed to say it, not like every 5 seconds like Alpha did, which I like, because if it calls for it, it calls for it, and you don't have to do it all the time. Yeah, but Alpha, man, just mishandling the Rangers the first time he meets. And I love how the Rangers are all scared of him, because wouldn't you? You step into the spaceship and some fucking robot with beady yellow eyes is coming after you, just dragging you left and right. Like, there's four of you. Wait, wasn't there five? Oh, there you are. Yoink! Poor Billy. But yeah, that's how I would react if I saw a robot just run and they're all suspicious of it. Like Alpha going like, why are you all looking at each other? Is that a human thing? Oh, and Zordon, Bryan Cranston, the man of the hour. I love this version of Zordon, because in TV show, he was like this kind mentor. This Zordon didn't give a fuck. And I love how he goes like, Alpha, where are my warriors? Where are my warrior Power Rangers? They're right here, Zordon. They're these teenagers. And Zordon looks at him and is like, what do you mean, teenagers? Like, he was so mad. I like that. It's like, really? And he even said, Zordon said, the fate of the Earth depends on teenagers?
What an asshole!
And I was so hoping Alpha would stay with attitude. But no, you had a, no, he didn't say it. Man, if you had a good chance to say that line, it would be that moment. Because imagine if he did say with attitude. Zordon would just give him the death eyes, like, get the fuck out of here, Alpha. Just get out. But yeah, Zordon playing the worn out army vet who's been into battles and has seen some shit. This is a different Zordon, not the kind hearted mentor we know and love and shit. He's an asshole, but he's a good asshole. And the only reason he brought the Power Rangers over is because he wants to be Red Ranger in. What an asshole, but it was awesome though. It's like, I only brought you here so I could become the Red Ranger, you fuckers. Because look at you kids. You're kids. You're teenagers. Fuck you all. I want to be the Red Ranger. That was pretty funny, though. But it was awesome at the same time. All right. So, of course, we had our bonding moment, of course, because you have to have a bonding moment. It's like, what did you do to get here? Blah, 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 blah. And Billy goes like, I blew up a toaster in my locker. So basically, like, Breakfast Club, where Anthony Michael Hall's character did something like not that big but winds up in detention. Yeah. And whatever picture Kimberly did, I want to know what kind of picture she put in. Like, was that chick like fucking a guy? Cause goddamn, it made it seem like it was a really bad picture, a very inappropriate picture. Also, I love how in the trailer they show Jason and Kim kissing, but they don't show it at all in this movie. So that's traitor bait to get people talking. Another scene they didn't have in the movie is whoever that was on the goddamn train doing ninja flips and moves. Not one time did they show that. But yeah. Again, Zordon's an asshole, and I love every minute of it. Rita Repulsa, played by Elizabeth Banks. Goddamn, she's insane. It's like, they find her in a fishing boat. Jason's dad, of all people, finds her, like, dead and shit. This ain't your normal kids show, kids. And they put her down, and, like, some cop comes in, the poor cop dies. Like, people die, man, people die. And then she goes on, and fuck, she's looking for gold. She's basically going, like, I must find the precious, I must find gold to get my gold on. The precious, the precious. And she kills a bum. At least I think she killed a bum, but the bum showed up later, tied up, and I think he got died after that. I don't know. Some stuff in this movie. But yeah, Elizabeth Banks, though. Apparently she doesn't know she's a lady, because she goes in a jewelry store. And the cop says, like, lady, put your hands up. And Rita goes, like, lady, I like that. So apparently she didn't know she was a lady. Cool. Ha. Huh. But Rita, though, still insane. And this Rita is not to be fucking messed with, man, because she burst into Trini's bedroom at night and just destroys the shit out of the wall. And not one time did we ever see Trini's parents walk in and say, what the fuck happened here? Like, at the end, you see them, like, repainting the shit. But how did that conversation go when they see that? Like, Trini, what the fuck did you do? Some alien came over and tried to kill me. pee in this cup. Yeah, no questions asked, so I guess it's normal for your daughter to mess up her bedroom? Because they did say that Trini is a fucking troublemaker. Okay, no questions then? Alright, okay. Alrighty then. Also, the Power Rangers train in this movie, which I like, because you know, in the first episode, they automatically know how to fight and how to do their moves and shit. Although it is Super Sentai footage, and they said like, oh, the powers, they made us know how to fight and shit. I think they went like almost 2 weeks training and fucking up, because Zordon did say, or was it Alpha, that said in 11 days Rita is going to destroy the Earth. And yeah, you can see Jason just scratching the days of gone by on the wall, which is pretty cool, because yeah, training to be protectors of the Earth doesn't take one day. It takes a multiple of days. And yeah, I enjoy that very much. Like, they're like fucking up and they don't know what they're doing. And even Zordon tells them to go home, because even he's saying like, this is pointless. I love this Zordon. He's such a skeptic. Not like the kind-hearted mentor that he is on the show. Alright, I'm gonna cut off here because it's 20-minute camera vault, and I'll be back. And we're back. So yeah, the mentor, such an asshole. Such an asshole. Okay, then we get to where Rita tells the Rangers to come on over to a fight. And they tie the Rangers up, Rita does, and apparently Billy dies. No, apparently he doesn't die. Billy does die, and I'm thinking the entire time, it's like, no, he's not dead, he's not dead, and they're dragging off his body, and I'm going, God damn, they really went dark on this movie. I applaud you, Saban, I applaud you. Because the kids behind me were going like, Daddy, why is Billy actually dead? The father's like, going like, I don't know, son, I don't know. And the entire time I'm thinking like, what's the dumb thing they're gonna do to bring Billy back? Is it the power of love? Because, you know, they would do that in the Power Rangers. No, it's not the power of love. It's Zordon stop being an asshole and goes like, you know what? Because, like, Alpha said, like, oh, the morphing grid is open. Go, Zordon. You can get out of the goddamn wall instead of the tube. Oh, that's another thing I like, because instead of being in the tube, Zordon is all over the wall and you can move around. That's pretty awesome, though. But yeah, instead of being an asshole, Zordon thinks of other people for one. He goes like, it's deserved for someone else. And then Billy's alive. Yay! And then he dies again, apparently. I'm going to, goddamn, Billy, how many times do you have to die? But I'll get to that later. So, it comes to the point. The morphing scene. Meh! It's pretty cool. Like, them surrounding a circle and the camera going all the way around. That was pretty epic. And I'm sitting there going like, do it! Do it! Say the line! Say the line! And then Jason goes, it's morphing time. And I had chills in my arm. And I'm going like, yes! And they're going around and literally, like, the morphing scene was alright. Like, kind of creepy, though, because they literally morph into it because their skin becomes armor. Well, yeah, it's morphing, so I can see that. But the thing is, when they open their visors, you can see a little bit of a clearing there because they're in their head, and I'm thinking, like, isn't it stuck to their head? But no, apparently only their helmet, but the rest of their suit is on their skin, which is kind of creepy, but whatever. It's a different take. And then we got the Power Ranger walk. Going out of the goddamn power chamber, the command center, the spaceship, whatever they call it. And I shit you not, I shed a tear, because that was very epic. Only thing missing was the Power Ranger theme song, Go Go Power Ranger, but I'll get to that in a bit. Yeah, so they go out and they fight the Putty Patrol. And the Putty Patrol, this is what the Putty Patrol should look like. Because yeah, show Power Rangers, skinny Putty Patrollers going like this. And then in season 2, having the Z in the middle, the most easiest weak point ever. And I don't know why they never just do it in the first thing, is punch him in the Z. instead of just fucking around and kicking everywhere else except the Z, and then at the end they go hit the Z and then it disintegrate. These putties are steroid version of putties, and I like it. I like it a lot. And speaking of the Zeo crystals, Segway. That wasn't a segue. Segway. Zeo crystals are in Angel Grove somewhere, and only Billy can pinpoint where they are. And they are at Krispy Kreme. Wow. It got annoyed me so much after a while where they kept on saying, go to the Krispy Kreme, go to the Krispy Kreme. At first I found it funny, like the first 2 times. But then they kept on saying, I was like, God damn, now I want to eat Krispy Kreme. Biggest commercial tie-in ever. Wow. Especially, yeah. It was a giant commercial, because literally, Rita was asking Billy, where is the Power Ranger Zeo crystals at the Krispy Kreme? What's the Krispy Kreme? It's the main one. It's a classic. It's whatever the fuck he said, and they're both having a conversation about Krispy Kreme. And I'm thinking, like, any minute now there's a Krispy Kreme logo gonna show up at the bottom. Krispy Kreme! And then the other one is where, like, she walks into the Krispy Kreme and just sits, stands there eating a fucking donut. Okay, we get it. Krispy Kreme, whatever. Go buy Krispy Kreme donuts. Jesus Christ. Yeah. Then the Zords came to the Power Ranger theme song. I shed another tear because I'm going like, yes! Because they're running towards battle and go, go, Power Rangers! It was in the background, and Billy's driving his Zord backwards. Awesome. Because in the show, he was saying, like, oh, these powers, they know how to drive these Zords. And in this one, it's like, I'm riding backwards, guys. Yeah. Goldar I'll get to in a minute. Because you know, I bet you know what I'm going to talk about Goldar. Oh, Make My Monster Grow is in this. And I got a big smile on my face when she said that. Make my monster grow. Good. Yes. Okay, I'm going to save that towards the end. Another thing I like. Jason's dad is looking for Jason in the middle of Angel Grove. And he's going like, where are you? He's on the phone saying like, come on, Jason, pick up. Where the hell are you? He's like, I'm here in the corner of Mariner Bay and Reefside. I got what you got there, Saban. Really? Mariner Bay and Reefside, eh? Lightspeed Rescue and a Dino Thunder reference in one place. I like it. I like it a lot. But Megazord fights. I'll talk about the Megazord at the end. But the final battle. What? Pitch slaps Rita into space. And they even said, did you just slap Rita? It's like, yes. Yes, I did. Okay, then. And then we see Rita going into space, and I'm thinking, like, please go to the moon. Please go to the moon. Please go to the moon. And then she is frozen solid. I'm like, God damn it. But is she going to the moon? Maybe? Yes? And yeah. Also, when rewind a bit, Jason saves his dad. He saves his dad in a burning car. And I was back in my mind thinking, like, Time Force. Just like how Wes saved his dad. And I was expecting the visor to be broken. And he can see like half the thing broken. And his dad sees him and then accepts him to be a Power Ranger. Just like in Time Force. But no. He just rescues him and then he just runs away. And somehow Jason's dad knows it's Jason. Because at the end of the movie he just clips on the fucking newspaper ad that says Heroes Save the Day. Onto the fridge, like he's a proud father, because he somehow knows, just because the Red Ranger ran away. I don't know how, but okay. Cameo time! At the end, Jason David Frank and Amy Jo Johnson take pictures of the Megazord. Yeah, and they're wearing green and pink, which is awesome. Great cameo, and I love how in the credits, they're labeled as Cameo number one and cameo number two, instead of saying bystander number one and bystander number two. Ah, so great, so great. And yeah, so we got the end movie, and Trini's brothers are saying, like, who's the best ranger, and they're saying, like, I like the pink, I like the blue, and Trini goes, like, I like the yellow, what do you think of the yellow? It's like, yeah, she's a good one. Why do you think it's a he? Ah, just like Zach did in the original show. It's like, what do you think of the black one? Also, we got sequel baiting going on after the movie's over, because we got a mid-credit roll. The detention teacher goes like, ah, we got a new classmate, Tommy Oliver. He keeps on saying that name as we pan into a green hoodie with no one there, and in the background you hear Tommy Oliver. And someone in the audience goes, Bueller. Love that guy. Don't know who that guy is, but you're awesome. Also, some guy yelled out, like, what the fuck? Save that for the sequel, man. Which I agree, but they didn't show his face. They just showed the green hoodie and just said his name. Setting up for a sequel. Hooray. Because if they did show whoever was playing Tommy Oliver, I'd be mad. But no, they actually were smart and just said his name and just showed the green hoodie. That's good thinking. Okay, so to the stuff I couldn't stand. All right, like I was talking about the visors. I was happy about that at first because I found, hey, Ninja Steel did it. Why not? And the Power Rangers took off their helmets in season 2 sometimes. So I go like, hey, why not? But the thing is though, the entire goddamn battle scene is just with their visors open. Fucking hell, it annoyed me after like 5 minutes. I'm like, close your goddamn visor. Just do it. I don't want to see your faces. This is, God damn it, they're doing the whole Judge Dredd Sylvester Stallone thing. Which my friend did say, they're just, as a reason, just to show their face. And I was going like, nah, they're not going to do that. Egg on me, because I didn't think they were going to do that. That was the one thing I didn't like, because it annoyed the shit out of me. Like, the goddamn visors open the entire time during battle. And the only time they close it is when Jason is fighting the helping his father, or when the Rangers are fighting the Punny Patrollers on top of the mountain. That's it. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that the Zords are amazing looking. Or I did say that, I don't know. Another one thing I didn't like, I still don't like the Megazord design. It looks really weak. But the thing I didn't like at all, we had no Megazord transformation scene, which bugged the shit out of me. Because they get thrown down into the goddamn pit by Goldar. I'll get to him in a minute. And that reminded me of season 1 where they the Zords were put into the pit and they got destroyed and shit. I'm thinking, okay, Billy's gonna die again. It looks like that because it's goddamn. But then they come back into the mist of smoke and you see the Megazord's arm and shit. I'm thinking, come on! We don't get a Megazord transformation scene. Really? What's the point? We barely got a Power Ranger morph. Now we don't get a Megazord transformation scene. Oh, come on. Really? That's the one thing Power Ranger fans love. Like, watching the Power Rangers morph and the Zords coming together to make a Megazord. Because we all love that. Because like, no matter what show it is in, we all watch it. Just look on YouTube and look at Megazord transformation scenes. And get the highest views. Because they're awesome. But no. Steam of smoke, and we got the shitty fucking Megazord. At least it looks better than the 95 version, but the Turbo movie version looks better than this piece of shit. But yeah, also, Billy. All our Zords combined together. It's like a big Mama Zord. No, wait, I can do better. Megazord! I go like, good. I love you, Billy. I love you. Goldar, again. And I like how he looks like in the trailer, because he looks just like a big gooey cheese. Still looks big gooey cheese, but it's Goldar. He should be badass. Come on, Saban. Give me something. He did stuff, but really, he looks weird as hell. Yeah. But other than that, the visor's being opened all the goddamn time. No bulk and skull references. Well, at least have some. Well, we got one bully. That's iconic. Yeah, kid, but fuck. Oh, shit. But that's all I can think of about the stuff I don't like. I was going to say Alpha 5, but he grew on me. Because, like, hell yeah, I admit it, he grew on me. But hey, wait. Also, yeah, you got power coins, but no morphers. But come on, Billy, you gotta invent the morphers for the next movie. You gotta do that. Come on. Come on! Yeah. And I'm still trying to figure out how Latino parents named their kid Trini. Yeah. Alright, that's basically all I have to say about this movie. Oh, in the ending, they got the lightning bolt, which was awesome. Pretty cool. Yeah, and that's all I gotta say. I'll give this an 8 out of 10. Because the three things I did not like, 8. Wait, no. Fuck. I'm bad at math. But whatever, I give it an 8 out of 10. There's two, yeah. But not the best, not the worst, but I'll give it an 8. I enjoyed it. It brought a smile to my face. Some things I didn't like, but hey, you're gonna love some stuff, you're gonna hate some stuff. Whether or not, good job, Saban, was the new vision of this stuff. And again, good job of not showing, actually, the character of Tommy. I like that. But anyways, that's it for now, Humanoid Nation. Humanoid Freak Out, bye.